Picture a city emerging from the sea, a bold vision taking shape just north of Manila. This isn't just an airport, it's the Manila International Airport, a $23 billion project set to become one of the largest in the world. Spanning 2,500 hectares, larger than Mandaluyong and San Juan combined, and featuring a vibrant seaport, it's not just a hub for planes, but a city designed for the sky. For 50 years, replacing Manila's Ninoy Aquino International Airport seemed like a dream that would never land. Since the 1970s, planners warned that NAIA's capacity wouldn't keep up with the nation's growth. Decades of proposals, studies, and blueprints came and went, each one stalling before construction could begin. The airport became more than infrastructure. It became a symbol of frustration and national gridlock. By 2024, NAIA was pushed to its limits, operating 40 to 50% over capacity, a stark reminder that the Philippines' aviation future could no longer wait. Enter the new Manila International Airport. This multi-runway megaproject is designed to do more than relieve congestion. It will reset the nation's aviation landscape. With scalable capacity and world-class facilities, NMIA promises to unlock economic growth and finally end a 50-year struggle. From dream to reality, this airport is proof that sometimes the impossible is just a matter of time and ambition. When it's complete, the new Manila International Airport will handle hundreds of millions of passengers a year, finally easing the chronic congestion, flight delays, and bottlenecks that have long plagued the nation's skies. The deadlock that stifled progress for decades was shattered in 2019. Under President Rodrigo Duterte, the Philippine government didn't just approve another airport plan, it endorsed the boldest infrastructure project in modern Philippine history. What made this moment historic was the approach. Instead of relying solely on public funds, the government embraced a private sector proposal. This shift signaled more than construction. It was a declaration of political will, a promise to overcome past failures through private expertise, capital, and efficiency. It marked the start of a new era in Philippine infrastructure. What sets this airport apart is its vision as an aerotropolis, a city built around an airport. Here, the airport is no longer just a hub for planes. It becomes the heartbeat of a metropolitan economy. Concentric rings radiate from the runways, logistics parks and distribution centers at the core, followed by offices, hotels, and conference spaces, and finally residential neighborhoods for the people who keep it running. All rings are linked by high-capacity roads, railways, and utilities, creating a seamless, dynamic ecosystem where commerce, innovation, and community thrive together. The new Manila International Airport isn't just a destination. It's the origin point of a city, an economy, and a future designed for the 21st century. The new Manila International Airport isn't just infrastructure. It's the spark for a new economic powerhouse, positioning the Philippines for global competitiveness for decades to come. But building an airport for the next century isn't just about size. It's about intelligence, resilience, and foresight. Take the runways. Unlike NAIA's two intersecting strips that often cause delays, this airport starts with four massive parallel runways, designed like upgrading from a narrow village road to a multi-lane superhighway. Engineered to Category 4 precision standards, they guide aircraft even in near-zero visibility using the latest landing systems. Multiple planes can take off and land at once, and in the future, the airport can expand to 6 runways, creating one of the world's most efficient hubs. The air traffic control tower will feature panoramic digital displays and integrated radar, tracking every aircraft across the Philippine flight information region with pinpoint accuracy. Inside, the terminal is equally impressive. spanning 350,000 square meters, roughly 70 football fields, the design is simple, intuitive, and stress-free. From check-in to security, immigration, and your gate, passengers move along a seamless, logical path. No confusing twists, no long walks, just smooth, effortless travel. Every element, from runways to terminals, has been designed to solve the past's problems and anticipate the future's demands. This isn't just an airport, it's a gateway, a city in motion, and a blueprint for the Philippines' next century of growth. The new Manila International Airport is designed to make travel effortless, tackling congestion and stress with smart, forward-thinking features. Check-in will be faster thanks to multi-airline common counters, while security uses advanced CT scanners that let you leave laptops and liquids in your bag. Immigration? Automated biometric gates verify identities in seconds, not minutes. Passenger comfort extends to the lounges, with soaring ceilings, natural light, and acoustics that soften the usual airport din. Boarding is faster too, with dual bridges on wide-body aircraft allowing twice as many passengers to embark at once. But the true engineering marvel lies beneath. The airport is rising from reclaimed land. To build on soft marine clay, engineers are driving nearly 30,000 extra-long piles, some 75 meters deep, essentially creating a forest of concrete beneath the surface. Preloading with vertical drains squeezes decades of natural compaction into months, ensuring a stable foundation. Being coastal, the airport is built for the climate of the future. The site is raised 5 meters above sea level, protected by a 4.5 kilometer seawall of interlocking blocks that absorb wave energy. Underground drainage canals and pumping stations move millions of liters of water per hour, keeping typhoons at bay. Runways use porous asphalt to prevent flooding, and the terminal rests on seismic isolation bearings to withstand earthquakes. Every detail, from check-in to foundations, has been engineered to last, making the new Manila International Airport not just a hub, but a fortress of innovation and resilience. The construction of the new Manila International Airport is nothing short of a modern miracle, turning sea into land. Over 2,500 hectares of Manila Bay have been reclaimed, with enough sand to fill thousands of Olympic swimming pools poured into the shallow waters, moved by a fleet of specialized dredging ships working nonstop. But creating land was only the beginning. The soft clay beneath is like a giant sponge, threatening to sink under the airport's weight. Engineers drove tens of thousands of concrete piles, some as long as a 25-story building, to reach solid ground. Vertical drains act like giant straws, squeezing water from the clay to accelerate settlement that would naturally take decades. Hundreds of sensors track every millimeter of movement, ensuring the foundation is safe and stable. Yet the transformation hasn't come without costs. Nearby fishing grounds are blanketed in silt, shrinking catches and threatening the livelihoods of local families who have fished these waters for generations. Environmental experts warn of long-term impacts on marine ecosystems and changing flood patterns along the coast. Climate adds another layer of challenge. Built just meters above sea level in a typhoon-prone country, the airport relies on raised platforms and a protective seawall, but some scientists question whether it will withstand rising seas decades from now. The new Manila International Airport is a triumph of engineering, but also a reminder. Building the future means facing immense challenges. Practical, environmental, and climatic. Every ton of sand, every pile driven, is a step toward a vision that must balance innovation with the reality of nature. The departure of international dredging giant Boskalis from the project sent ripples through the industry, raising questions about technical hurdles and timelines. While other contractors pressed on, it underscored a simple truth. even the most experienced companies face unexpected obstacles when building something this massive, and the challenges are far from over. The story of the new Manila International Airport unfolds against a backdrop of fierce regional competition. Across Southeast Asia, nations are racing to build the airports of the future. Vietnam is constructing a $16 billion hub near Ho Chi Minh City, ultimately targeting 100 million passengers. Thailand is transforming a former military field into the $9 billion Utha Pau Eastern Aviation City, with runways, cargo terminals, and high-speed connections to Bangkok. Cambodia's Teco International Airport, larger than Manila's project, opened its first phase in September 2025, setting a new regional benchmark. In this race, controlling major air hubs means more tourism, more investment, and stronger global business connections. The new Manila International Airport is the Philippines' bold bet to compete and secure a premier aviation position in Southeast Asia. Yet an even bigger challenge looms: climate change. Built on reclaimed land in Manila Bay, the airport faces sea level rise and potential land subsidence. Melting ice caps swell oceans, while the reclaimed ground slowly sinks, a combination that could threaten operations decades from now. For the Philippines, the new airport is more than steel and concrete. It's a statement of ambition, a race for regional relevance, and a test of resilience against the forces of nature. Engineers behind the new Manila International Airport highlight a suite of protective measures: elevated runways, reinforced seawalls, and advanced drainage systems designed to withstand extreme weather. Yet some climate scientists warn that as seas rise and storms grow stronger, even these safeguards may not be enough. They point to Japan's Kansai International Airport, another airport on reclaimed land, which has faced decades of costly interventions to combat sinking and flooding. The question isn't just whether Manila's airport can open successfully, it's whether it can remain safe, operational, and economically viable for the next 50 years. The airport sits at the crossroads of two forces: the drive for regional economic competitiveness and the relentless pressure of environmental change. Its success will be measured not only by passenger numbers or rankings, but by its ability to adapt to a changing climate. A key part of making this vision possible is the build-operate-transfer model. Under a BOT agreement, the government grants a private company the rights to finance, design, build, and operate a major project, like an airport, for a set period, often decades, after which control returns to the public. Private operators bring capital, expertise, and efficiency, with revenues from operations helping recoup their investment. The appeal is clear: governments can deliver world-class infrastructure without adding public debt, while private firms are incentivized to build on time, on budget, and operate efficiently. But BOT carries risks too. Poorly structured contracts, weak oversight, or overly optimistic revenue forecasts can leave taxpayers exposed or slow progress. For Manila's airport, success will hinge on balancing ambition, expertise, and foresight in an era of climate uncertainty. The new Manila International Airport is a real-world example of how the build-operate-transfer model can work. A private conglomerate won the rights to finance, build, and operate the airport and its surrounding aerotropolis for a 50-year concession, taking on financial and operational risks before handing it back to the government. For the Philippines, this means a world-class gateway and long-term economic engine without diverting funds from health or education. For the developer, it's a long runway, literally and figuratively, to recover costs and earn returns. BOT is pragmatic. It leverages private capital and expertise, ties success to performance, and ensures public ownership returns in top condition with trained local staff ready to operate it. The economic promise is immense. Construction alone is expected to generate over 100,000 jobs, from engineers and operators to administrative staff. Once operational, the airport and its supporting businesses could create more than 1 million direct and indirect jobs. These go far beyond pilots, flight attendants, and ground crew. Hospitality, retail, logistics, and manufacturing sectors will all see a surge in demand, creating stable careers and incomes for generations in Bulacan. For years, limited airport infrastructure has held the Philippines back from reaching its full tourism potential. A modern airport capable of handling 100 million passengers annually could change that, doubling tourist arrivals, boosting spending on hotels, restaurants, tours, and souvenirs, and creating a ripple effect of economic activity that benefits countless small businesses nationwide. A world-class airport also sends a strong signal to foreign investors. The Philippines is open for business. Companies looking to set up regional headquarters or manufacturing hubs often prioritize locations with excellent air connectivity. The new airport could attract investment in electronics, manufacturing, and business process outsourcing, generating high-quality jobs and transferring valuable skills to the local workforce. The airport effect is already visible in Bulacan and surrounding areas, where property values are climbing as developers anticipate economic growth. New residential subdivisions, commercial centers, and industrial parks are planned along transportation corridors, following the aerotropolis model, where cities naturally grow around major aviation hubs. But with growth comes important questions about equity. Rising land values benefit investors, but local residents on fixed incomes may face higher living costs. Fishing communities displaced by reclamation may struggle to share in the airport's economic boom. The true measure of success won't just be tourists or jobs, but how widely the benefits are shared. The new Manila International Airport isn't just about travel. It's a test of the Philippines' ability to build a sustainable, inclusive future. The future is taking flight, but where it lands remains uncertain.